Hello everybody, I'm here today with Dr. Shervin Molayem, and we spent the day together getting to know the magnetic mallet. We had a bunch of procedures, and I'm going to turn it over to him and have him tell you about his experience.
Hi, we're out here today in California, in Los Angeles area. We had a few patients, implant patients and sinus lift and ridge aug. It was a little bit of a mix. Today was my first time ever using magnetic mallet. I just received the package and I had a really, really great experience. So I'd like to talk about it and answer questions later on. If there is a forum for that, I can be available as a resource. But my experience was such that this was, I believe, it a game changer as far as my my ability to be able to add different armamentarium to my repertoire. I still had the handpiece out if I needed a section of tooth and my drill kit, but I was definitely using the magnetic mallet more than I thought I was. I thought I was just going to use it for like a sinus that I placed. I drilled the osteotomy sites for the implants. And the good thing about it was, even though sometimes I had enough bone ridge, I was able to use it and get even more bone. So if I was going to use, let's say, a 3.5 millimeter diameter, I now got to a 4.3, and big difference, because and all of a sudden when you have your final result in your crown, your ridge has been reestablished. It doesn't look like there's any kind of void or indentation. A few things as far as the magnetic mallet, it could be used for extractions, for sinus lifts, for ridge expansion. I found the best use for it was the ridge expansion. For me personally, there is no actual removal of the bone when you're actually quote unquote drilling or creating osteotomy. It starts with a very pointy first drill, which looks like this. You got this convex tip, and the markers go from 7 to 8.5 to 10, 11.5, 13. And once you get in there, then it goes into the more flat type of tip, which is pushing the bone up into, if you're doing a sinus lift, it pushes it up into the sinus. And if not, it's just condensing the bone around the implant. So that was key. Also, as far as the sinus, I was able to place a 5 millimeter implant in a thin ridge. So one of my cases, I had a 4.5 millimeter crestal bone. I put a 10 millimeter implant. I expanded the width of the bone slightly and put a 5 by 10 millimeter implant, which I videotaped, so you guys may have access to that. Overall, I felt safe, especially in this post-COVID world, less aerosol. During implant placement, I did not need to use water, which was just amazing. There's no friction with the magnetic mallet. There's no heat generation, so there's no water needed. There's no aerosol as a result. I love that. The speed of my extractions were increased. I should say decreased my speed. And that's just when you're getting in a certain position, trying to get your elevator at a root. If you have this pressure that's being given and it's not your own pressure, it's a controlled pressure. Sometimes I'm trying to elevate, and when you get in with an elevator, you could slip even. I felt like since they're in 1.5 millimeter increments, I can literally just go at my own pace, and just gnaw and get in there and to elevate. And then you can switch it off and go to the other direction and until the root gets loose, and then you just come in with your own elevator and it comes right out. So that was huge. Really happy about that. Just overall really excited to keep using this. Learning curve wise, I feel like day one, even halfway through the day, I felt pretty comfortable. The only thing I had to do is just keep this sheet with me this first day just so I can get used to the numbers. But other than that, it's just like, you know, placing implants or anything else. In fact, I want to say I had even more control with the magnetic mallet than I did not having it. And that's just because of the 1.5 millimeter movements versus if I'm drilling, it doesn't stop at 1.5 millimeters. I'm actually putting force, and it could, you know, possibly go into the sinus, or you can go past the osteotomy depth that you desire. So, I mean, I just named so many things, so many different weapons that this allows you to use.
Sounds like it put control back into your hands.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's great. So would you, what would you tell your colleagues about it?
I jump on it.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, thanks, doctor.
Of course.